All right, guys, I have a treat for you tonight. Before us, we have a beautiful Tower of London produced British Navy Sea Service pistol. I have had the privilege of going through and cleaning it out and cleaning it in such a way as to not affect any of the historical value, just stopping any of the rusting that might be taking place. I've gone through and I've cleaned the stock and I've applied some moisture agent back into the stock so as to stop any cracking. You know, with age they get dry cracks, and so to stop that and just kind of clean it up, and the owner is certain he wants to fire it, so I have gone through and made sure that it is safe to fire and made sure everything, the sears and everything, are still good. It checks out 100%. It's in beautiful condition, and something that is really rare on this particular piece is all the assembly numbers match on this gun, which is so rare to have. Lock, stock, barrel, brass castings, everything has an assembly number. They weren't serial numbered at the time, it's just a Roman numeral assembly number, and they all match, and that is just so rare. So I wanted to give you guys a look at it. I don't know, the guy that is the owner of this is local. I might be able to get a shooting video from it, but I don't know. And in case we don't get a good shooting video, I at least wanted to just make it to where you guys could see this, because being able to see and handle something like this is extremely rare. And like I said, it was a privilege to work on it. I'm going to pick it up so you guys can get a little bit of a closer look at some of the markings on it. As you guys can see there, there's the Tower of London marks. And there's the King's Cipher and the Broad Arrow. Now, this was an actual Tower of London produced piece, because on the opposite side of the lock, there is the initial of the person who proofed the lock, and there would, if it was an outsourced part, it would have a initial of the company that made it, but it has no initials of any outside company, so it was definitely not an outsourced part. It was actually produced in the Tower of London. There you guys can see the touch hole, and that is perfect placement and perfect size. You cannot ask for anything nicer than that. There's the frizzen face, beautiful frizzen face. It's still hard, didn't have to do anything to it there. I'm gonna look at the proofs on the barrel, the proof mark. Beautiful. There's another one there. And you might be able to see right here, this is the 1807 storage mark. There's some more proofs on the stock here. Take a look at them one at a time. Hopefully the camera can pick it up. This camera is a lot better at picking up things than my old camera. I don't know how many of you miss my old camera, but I sure don't. There's the proof there. So, beautiful, beautiful gun. I measured the bore. It's about 54 to 55 caliber. If my camera will focus on it, you'll see there that it's not quite concentric. But for a smooth bore, that's plenty good. Usually they are, being that this one was produced probably in the Napoleonic Wars. Even though the quality is top notch, I'll bet it was probably produced with haste. Here you have the belt clip. It's what you would use to attach the pistol to your belt. Very rare to still have these on Navy pistols and have them where they're not broken. I mean, look at that. Here's the maker's mark on the inside of the trigger guard. Hope you can see that there. There's a crown and a 7. That is the maker's code. Beautiful. Like I said, it's so rare that you see guns like this anymore. This is probably a $4,000 to $5,000 piece. I think maybe I could talk him into it. Talk him into selling it to old Murphy's Muskets. Maybe. But somehow I kind of doubt it. I mean, just look at that beautiful wood. Oh, and check this out, guys. I might have to go off camera for a second for this. I'm gonna pull the ramrod out a little bit. The original ramrod. How cool and rare is that? That after all these years, it still hasn't been replaced. And the wood is just beautiful. As you can see, there's not a single repair anywhere. Well, guys, I hope you enjoyed this look at this rare, rare piece. And hopefully, I'll have something like this of my own down the road to shoot and review. Although I doubt it will be this nice, because finding them this nice is really difficult. Gosh, that's a beautiful pistol. Like I said, maybe, cross your fingers for me, we might have a shooting video down the road. Depends on the owner and what he wants to do. But as you can see, it's clean, it's beautiful. It's ready to either go into storage or do whatever he wants with it. For those of you who want to see this pistol in greater detail, I have a lot of pictures of it that I'm going to be uploading to my Facebook page, especially pictures of it disassembled and looking at all the different assembly numbers and just a lot better quality close-up pictures. Just for those of you who might be interested, you can find me at Murphy's Muskets on Facebook. And if you like the page, it's a really good way to keep up with me. I would say it's an even better way to keep up with me than here on YouTube. It's hard to get to everybody on YouTube these days, and I can access Facebook from my phone. So if that's something that you guys might be interested in, I'll put a link to my Facebook page down in the description. Feel free to go there. That's about it, guys. I will catch you all later.